Amcoil Arena Cross heads south to the Lone Star State, the race for the championship gets even tighter. Three riders battling for the final spot in the top 10, and their championship hopes are on the line. Featuring Ricky Carmichael's Road to Supercross, deep in the heart of Texas on speed. Welcome inside, everyone. I'm Robbie Floyd, alongside Grant Langston, the Motocross Supercross champion. And the word of the week has been aggressive. Last week we saw it. Heat races, main events, last chance qualifier, and especially the head-to-head matchup.
Well, this has become a contact sport. Last week we saw it, a critical last lap, last corner pass by Kyle White on Daniel Blair to give him the main event. It was crucial. A lot of valuable points. We've seen Tyler Bowers have to come through the pack several times. Aggression is what it's all about right now.
That's all about Amcoil Arena Cross. This is a two-night weekend. Last night, main event number two. Let's take a look.
I'm bracket waiting for the Naked Stags creeping to start hitting the gate from the outside. Number four, Zach Ames takes the lead. But he is supercharged by his teammate, Tyler Bowers, elected the inside of the second row after the inversion of a solid out front. Later in the race, number two, Jeff Gibson gets a great drive from the roof, getting up the inside of Daniel Blair, taking that third and final podium position. Once again, Tyler Bowers does take both main event wins and the overall.
Now let's take a look at our championship point standings with Tyler Bowers well ahead of the rest of the field. 151 points separates first through 10th, but that's the cutoff. Really, the key is 11th and 12th place. Kyle White, 1 point out of the top 10. Steve Magus, 12 points out. They need to get in that top 10 if they're going to race for the championship. Now let's take a look at this Cedar Park track through Jeff Gibson's goggles in our GoPro track preview.
Slightly different layout this weekend. The start straight here is actually a pretty tough set of loops. Then comes into this relatively flat 180-degree left-hander. These rollers here, yeah, we've seen guys timing it. We've seen guys blitzing it. Nice ball turn. Two rhythms here. Nathan Skaggs did triple. The final pass number two in the last turn, then over the finish line, that whole jump. And that was a rapid
super. Great shot through the GoPro Hero 3. Thank you, Jeff Gibson. Now let's go down to our partner who will be giving us trackside insight throughout the evening, Ms. Christy Lee.
Number 19, Kyle White, only three races remaining, including tonight's event, before we clean the slate with the top 10 riders competing for the race for the championship at Little Rock. A lot of pressure on you. You're only in the 11th position right now, just on the cusp of that top 10, 1 point behind 10th position.
Yeah, it's been a long season, and we're where we wanted to be. You know, in August, I decided my goal was to be top 10. So I put in a lot of work. The team put in a lot of work, and we're where we need to be. We're within striking distance, so just going to try and put together a good three nights of racing and get where I need to be.
We've seen you competing in the lights class as well, all of the rounds, even last night. What made you decide to drop racing the lights and just focus on the main?
You know, last night I got out there and I had to go to the LCQ in the AX class, and then that leaves me with four back-to-back races. And after practice this morning, I decided, you know, I think I'm going to just pull out a lights class and focus on the class that I'm here for. Lights is nice to get extra time on the track and everything, but we're here for top 10 in the big class, and that's what we're going to go for.
Well, shifting your focus just to the main obviously paid off. You qualified with the third best lap time for tonight's main event races. That puts you on the front row, which is a huge advantage, and there was only a 0.4 of a second difference between the top three positions.
Yeah, got to focus on the big class this morning and came out top three, so that's where we need to be. Get a good gate pick, good start, and put us in a front row pick for the main event, hopefully.
And that definitely puts you in a good position trying to get into that top 10, although you will be competing with contenders like Zach Ames in second position and the championship points leader, Tyler Bowers, but you guys are so close right now on this front starting line.
Yeah, it's you know, we're going to be front row inside. That's where we need to be, and it puts you in a good position. If there's carnage or anything, we're in a position to come out clean.
Well, it should be some good racing tonight. Best of luck. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thanks, Christy. When Amcoil Arena Cross returns, it'll be time for heat race number one. Welcome back to Amcoil Arena Cross. It's time to fire them up here in just north of the capital of Texas in Cedar Park. Heat race number one of the Arena Cross class. These are not 450s. These are 250Fs. Everybody races the 250 machinery.
Absolutely, but
the way the speed these guys are going around here, it's almost like they're on 450s.
And as we take a look at the K&N starting grid for heat race number one, Zach Ames already with a main event victory this year. Kyle White, Ginolfi, those two guys battling it out for the championship, trying to get in that top 10. Jeff Gibson, who's looked strong as the years progress. Michael Willard, a pretty good field here in heat race number one.
This is a time when the nerves get up. You just want to get through this heat race safe and get into that main event with a good starting position.
It's going to be tough heading into that first turn. A little different than we've seen. A kink going to the left. Hayes with a good start on the inside. Looks like he's going to get the whole shot.
Out. Right behind him, Jeff Gibson, and then David Ginolfi in that third place. This is the start he needed to protect that 10th place in the points at the moment. So he's off to a good start, and right behind him, his little nemesis there, Kyle White, they've got their own little battle going on.
This is a 10-lap heat race. They're quick, around 21, 22 seconds, sometimes even less, as we start to see some pressure now being put on by Jeff Gibson. The team Faith KTM wants it. He's a new dad, a proud papa, and he's showing he's got the speed.
See the difference there in the rhythm section. Some of the guys electing, as we see our rider down, some of the guys there going double onto the tabletop and off. Zach Ames going triple, but not really any time difference at the moment. But Jeff Gibson looking very racy this weekend. Maybe that weekend off revitalized him.
Seat bouncing there. You're seeing the two different options. We saw it in our GoPro track preview as one rider off the track there. Both trying to set up in there. Most of the riders are using his outside berm, taking him in to look. There's a lot of inside line, but really not much of drive if you take that inside line. Oh,
little washout there from Zach Ames, no harm, no foul. But yeah, get it back to that turn. The berm is a little ways out, but you want to carry your momentum in those groups. These are pretty big technical groups, and they're going to get tougher, as you see here. But if you've got a guy right behind you, you're caught, you know, between a rock and a hard place. You may have to protect it inside, but unfortunately, you may not get to drive the groups. As you see, Ginolfi getting through the group solid, and Kyle White right behind him. Daniel Blair rounding out the top five.
Also, the top seven move directly onto the main events. The top four go to the head-to-head matchup, the bracket race. If you want to get in that top four, it's worth one valuable championship point if you can win the head-to-head bracket race.
Absolutely. We had Ricky Carmichael here last week, and he said that was some of the most incredible racing he's ever seen. So, folks, if you've never been in one of these events, I highly suggest coming and watching it live. TV sometimes just does not give you the whole picture.
Dropping down the number four of Zach Ames, who was out in front in main event number two last night, lost to his teammate Tyler Bowers, who seems to be riding at another level right now. It's kind of tough when your teammate is so fast. You almost don't want to give up too much information among the team.
Yeah, you know, at the end of the day, these guys, a lot of them, when you're on teams, you're friends, but you're still competitors. You know, I don't care what anyone says, this is not a team sport. You're out for yourself. Sometimes you get told to do things you don't want to do, like let a teammate buy for a championship. But I guess sometimes you have to listen to who's paying the bills, but it's an individual sport.
Ames, Gibson, Ginolfi, White, they're so far into that head-to-head bracket. Fifth place, Daniel Blair. Looks like the number 39 Honda in sixth, and seventh, Brandon Glenn. There's guys like Michael Willard on the outside looking in. They got to turn it up, guys that we're used to seeing directly into that main event.
Yeah, obviously there's always that last chance qualifier, but you never really want to be there because it's just that. It's your last chance. Someone hits you, a little mechanical, a bad start, they're short races. As a white flag comes out, yeah, Zach Ames, Jeff Gibson keeping them honest this whole race. Like you said, Gibby looking very racy this weekend. I really think that maybe having this baby revitalized him or, you know, put a little pep in the step.
We had a little sit-down interview with him earlier today. We'll watch that a little later on in our show. And the checkered flag comes out. Heat race number one is done. Zach Ames takes the victory. He's pumped about that. Gibby's going to finish second. Ginolfi and White move directly into that head-to-head matchup. And let's go down to the winner. And Zach Ames, great ride in heat one.
Yeah, thanks. You know, I just got off to a great start. I knew I needed to focus on my start. You know, that's what's been hurting me the past couple weeks. And, you know, I just focused on that and rode a solid heat race.
Zach Grant here. You've looked solid all year long. What is it going to take, though, for you to go and take it to your teammate?
I know. He's just another animal, man. And, you know, it takes some time to try to tame them things. But all animals are tameable, so I think I can get him.
All right, buddy. Good luck tonight. Great race.
All right. Thanks, Grant.
Heat race number one. We still have plenty more arena cross action.
we come back to just north of Austin, Texas, in Cedar Park for more Hams Oil Arena Cross here on Speed. Back to Hams Oil Arena Cross on Speed as we prepare for heat race number two. Let's take a look at the Thor starting grid. Tyler Bowers, the two-time defending champion, number one in this one. Kelly Smith, Nathan Skaggs, Willie Braddock, Steven Majan. But one rider we do not see out there, Christy Lee, has more on that.
Robbie, we're actually missing a key contender out there tonight. Mike McDade is not on our starting grid. He's actually not here. He left last night. I had a chance to get a hold of him earlier today. He had a big crash in main one, landing the catapult last night. You may remember he did go out and do one lap during main two, but that crash left him with a wrist injury and a mechanical on his bike. With the two combined, he decided to regroup and come back strong next weekend in Pennsylvania.
Thanks a lot, Christy, as we take a look and see how the rest of the riders, 15 more riders hit the track for the first time, and Bowers on that inside and takes another hole shot.
He didn't come into the whoops in the lead. He just carried more momentum there. Pity we're not going to see Michael McDade out there. We hope that he's all right and will return soon. He didn't seem to think it was too serious, but definitely too much pain to race tonight. Green flag means
go.
Race is all go. Everything's good and in order. And that's just what Tyler Bowers is all about.
Steve Majors in second to number 18. Another guy who's trying to get into that top 10 on the outside now. He can prove his point that he deserves their right. To be in that position right now.
Absolutely. He's got nothing to lose at this point. I mean, he's at 12 and a fair amount of points out of it. He's got to go out there, and for him, maybe winning is not realistic, but a podium or, you know, every main event, get out there and, you know, put the pressure back on the competition. Let them
crash. Nathan Skaggs, see him, rider number six, a guy who's been fast, very fast in the head-to-head matchup, and he can't quite figure out the starts, a decent start this time. He's currently in third, just behind him, the number five of Kelly Smith. Fifth is Jared Steinke, Willie Braddock, and Tanner Moore right now, the top seven of the transfer to the main.
See, this freight train of KTMs coming through there. That was the rollers where I was saying some of the guys kind of, you know, like Bowers, you know, with that upper body strength, he just kind of skips them. A lot of some of these guys kind of finding a rhythm and timing. As you see these groups get really tricky, that last group is kind of catching the guys out because they're kind of bouncing off of it and unsettling the bike into that turn. And also, too, now we're starting to see ruts developing. So all these little things play into making this track more difficult and more technical.
It gives the track characters. You're seeing Steve Majors, number 18, Motorsport.com, JVR, Fine Children, KTM, ahead of another duo of KTM riders. It's not even following the leader. They're trying to find something unique right now for later, don't you think?
Absolutely. You're always searching. I mean, even just with the naked eye sometimes, it looks like they follow each other. But you can move around on these tracks 6 inches. It's Kelly Smith doing exactly what I was predicting tonight. That is going to be a turn with a lot of passing because, like I said, the berm's pretty far out. But you have a tendency to go out there to get a run into the whoops. And immediately he puts a bike length between himself and Nathan Skaggs so that there's no retaliation as they come back to the same turn. Kelly Smith made the pass one lap earlier.
Basically saying, I'm giving you an option. I'm going to your front tire. You can either possibly crash or you can back off. I'm supposed to back off and still move on to the bike.
Exactly. That's exactly what a textbook block pass is all about. You're basically telling the guy, shut off or you're going down, my friend, because I'm taking your line away. As we get back to the leader, Tyler Bowers, look at him, solid in the whoops, man. This guy is just, I mean, he's money. Look at him. Wheel tap in there, skip those whoops, doesn't bounce coming out, three in. Stays nice and low, soaks it up with his legs. Good corner speed as he takes the white flag. This guy's like watching poetry in motion.
Almost a 3.5 second lead over Steven Majors and Tyler Bowers. Now you can see, just didn't want to make a mistake. A lap rider in front. We've seen guys go down in front of him on the last lap before. That's what a champion does. Don't put yourself in a bad situation. Still hits that triple. The right-hand turn. He's turning 20-second lap times and a nice tabletop to finish things up for Tyler Bowers on the Kawasaki ahead of 5 KTMs in a row. It's Majors, Smith, and Nathan Skaggs moving on to that head-to-head matchup. As we look at the Rocky Mountain ATV results, besides those four, you throw in Browning, Steinke, and Williams into the main events. Tanner Sawyer,
has to ride the last chance qualifier. Let's go down to Tyler Bowers, winner of heat race number two. And Tyler, was that not the perfect heat race for you?
Yeah, it was good. I actually didn't get a very good jump off the gate and just kind of shuffled through the first turn and killed the whoops right off the bat and then just kind of tried to run away with it from there, stay out of trouble. There was a lot of lappers kind of going everywhere. So, like I said, just try to stay out of trouble, focus on all my lines, and get ready for the main event.
Tyler, it's Grant here. I've been watching. I got a question for you. Do you think this is the best you've ever ridden? Because you look so smooth and confident out there.
No, I mean, I feel good here. You know, this weekend I feel really good. I feel really confident on the bike. My mechanic, Junior Jackson, has been doing a great job. We got the bike set up pretty much dialed. I think I got a lot of progress. If you talk to my trainer, Tyler Kalizak, over at the Rockwood Training Facility, he'll tell you we're still working on peaking. So we're getting them better every weekend, so I think every weekend you guys can expect to see more.
Nice.
All about the training. You're the only rider in the 22nd range. Could you drop it even lower than that?
Yeah, maybe. You know, if I can get around some of the labbers. This last heat race, there were some guys everywhere. So if I just focus on my lines to keep the bike flowing, and I'm sure the lap times will come.
Congratulations on another heat race win. Tyler Bowers, he doesn't have to worry about other riders, just one rider. When we return, it's head-to-head matchup. Tyler and the other guys go at it head-to-head.
Adeline, she's doing great. It's a whole new step in life, man. It's been surreal. Like, I'm just kind of sitting back and just kind of trying to soak it all in. During the delivery and everything, I stayed on two wheels. I kept it up, and I didn't pass out or anything. So it was definitely, it was awesome. The first arena cross I did, I was 15 years old in 1998. I've been doing arena cross for a long time. Did quite a few years back then, and then went to the Supercross Nationals for a while. And, I've definitely made a name for myself here in arena cross, and I really am comfortable here. And for a kid to come in arena cross, you know, and stepping up through, you know, it's, I want to say, you know, come into it with an open mind, trying to learn a lot. You know, it's really tight here. You know, you don't want to make mistakes, and there's little room for error, so you've really got to hone his skills, and he's got to learn to take advantage of that and just take one step at a time and learn. When we make the change over to the race for the championship, there is that opportunity to come back for the championship. You know, obviously right now, Tyler's got a huge lead on everybody. And it's going to be wiped clean here the next couple weeks. So when we come back to it, it's just kind of however it plays out. You know, I'm going to give it everything I got, but however the tables turn, that's where I end up. All I can do is go out and give it everything I got. And that's where it's going to fall. I can't control anything else. I can just try and do the best I can.
It was good to sit down and talk with Gibby. I still see that 15-year-old from 1998.
Well, he's grown up a little bit since then, but still a good guy at heart.
And he's going to be in the head-to-head matchup. It simply is that. You, your buddy, two laps, who's going to come out on top? Well,
I don't know so much about buddies, because it seems like in these two-lap races, there's no buddies out there. But we've seen how valuable it is, not just because at one point, but a few rounds ago, we saw a three-way tie for the win. Michael McDade, with that extra bonus point, went from third to actually winning the overall. So it's a big deal.
Championship points at stake. Let's get to it. Round two action of the head-to-head. Zach Ames and Jeff Gibson. Ames got the bye due to mechanical with Nathan Skaggs. And Kelly Smith was defeated by Jeff Gibson. Now these two guys going at it head-to-head.
This is nervous time. These guys are getting ready. Here we go. Gibby with a great launch, man. He's had good starts tonight. Climbing this really well.
When he does get that start, he closes off that inside when somebody's on it. That's what you should do.
Well, basically, you have to, because it's a 45 degree, so you're basically using the angle to sweep truck. Ames, though, not really quite close enough. This should be your best opportunity for a pass is this turn here, but he was a bike link back just a little too far away.
Here, that last right-hand turn. We'll see if Zach Ames can close in. He needs to bounce off that wall. Seeing the rhythm by Gibson, you're seeing the blow through by Ames. Both riders opting to triple. That's really not going to set things up for different lines. And Jeff Gibson, number two, moves on to the next round. Ames take the first round. Dave Ginobili goes up against Tyler Bowers in this round. The Mandigo Pickle on the left, number 14. He's looking to get a start and shut him off, but he backed out of it way early.
Yeah, Bowers can get the jump.
I like that.
You know, not following. That's the best thing you can do. But let's see if he can keep him in touch. I think Bowers is back. This guy's solid.
he has your best chance, I think, but you know, you've got to be right on the guy's rear wheel in order to dive on the inside.
And he's confident enough and great enough that he can cut across those hoops. Like you said, that's the fastest line. You're starting to see him test out the whoop section, a little wheel tack coming in.
I mean, he puts his bike wherever he wants. I mean, this guy is so strong. Takes a nice little victory there, and he's off to the final.
Aggressive was our word for the week, and we couldn't ask for a better pair. Jeff Gibson and Tyler Bowers in the final. Number one on the inside. Gibby's been getting great starts. Look for him to shut him down.
Great launch. He's got that thing dialed. This is exactly what he needed to do, get ahead of Tyler Bowers from the beginning.
This is going to be a good race.
Guarding that inside line, but look at the blow through. The number one, not opting to find
him. Now, let's see if he can do what we've been talking about. Can he? Watch to go up the inside here. Textbook pass. Nice maneuver. And close to the door on Gibson. Oh, they make contact.
Is that a brake check?
Yeah, that was a little brake check for sure. Put it this way, I don't think these guys send each other Christmas cards. So we've seen a lot worse. Can Gibby retaliate the last turn? Oh, more contact with Bowers. Takes it and that one valuable point.
Hey, those bikes have throttles. They also have brakes, and Gibby said, all right, I'll see you next week. That's what head-to-head racing is all about. Junior Jackson, take the bike and prepare it for the main event. We still have a lot of racing left here at Amsoil Arena Cross. Stick with us. Guys didn't make it directly into the main event. Now they line up for the LCQ, the last chance qualifier, only two move on. This eight lap race really is your go in the main or go home.
Yeah, trust me, you want to go to the main. None of these guys came all this way to go home, but most of our heavy hitters already in the main event, but definitely some notable names not in at the moment. Michael Willard, one of those guys, and in fact
Michael Lang also in there as well, I believe. He was fast last night. Might have even taken the victory in the lights as the 32nd board is out. So should be a good race. Willard, one of the guys, is trying to get in that top 10 in championship points. What a start from the outside. Tanner Moore with a great start. Whole shot from that outside gate.
Actually, I don't even see Michael Willard in this race at all. So maybe something happened, mechanical, maybe. I don't know. I didn't see what happened. Unfortunately, not out there, though. We don't see the number 9 PTM.
394, 10 or more in front. Jamie Starrett, the hard charger, 289 in second, trying to stay in that position to move on to the final out of Athens, New York. Both KTMs running to Tanner Sawyer, the rider in third. He's the one that has to pick up the pace. Third just gets his great seat to stand.
Yeah, absolutely. The front two guys, you know, they're going to try and play it smart. You know, you don't want to take each other out or get into a stuffy match and allow the rest of the pack to close up. Like you said, if you can keep a bike length to a gap, you don't have to protect those inside lines. You can run the whole berm, you know, flow the whole way through. So these front two guys doing exactly what they need to do to get the main event, just keeping that slight gap. Tanner Sawyer, who, if he wants to get through, needs to pick it up. Five bike lengths behind right now.
A little bit of a box. He's trying to wheel tap in the whoop section. Tannemore coming all the way from Auburn, Kansas, on Lefco MSR KTM. Derek just behind. He's going to keep holding on to that spot. You don't need to pass for the win. It's one gate pick. You do need to hold on this second.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, realistically, whether you go to the gate 15th or 16th, you're on the outside of the back row. So, you know, for these guys, it's the risk to reward factor. It's not worth really going for them. Unless the leader is holding you up and allowing the other guy behind to come and jeopardize that qualifying position, I think these guys are playing real smart.
Darren on the KTM of Little Rock, I believe one of dirt bike Mike students, a longtime fixture of Amsoil Arena Cross. And now you see those two separated themselves from the rest of the field. Brian Burns has now moved up into third, the 74 Honda.
And actually, looking at the lap time, the front three riders' lap times all within a tenth of a second of their best lap. So, you know, that's the thing. You know, that's why we say starts are so important, because the lap times are so close, it's hard to make up that ground. I mean, you get a bad start, you lose 50 yards in the first lap. It's so hard to gain that back. And the white flag comes out. Tanner Moore holding onto the lead. Davey Sterrett right behind him. Those two looking to make it through. And number 74, Brian Burns. Unfortunately, he looks like he's too far back to do anything about it on this final lap.
And when you're trying to play conservative, that's when things can sometimes jump up and grab you. That was almost the case for Tanner Moore. He takes the right-hand turn. He will get the 15th gate pick and move on to the final, along with the 289 of Davey Sterrett, making his first main event in the arena cross class this year. So the field is set for our two main events. When we come back, it's round five, main event time at Amsoil Arena Cross. The moment we've been waiting for, Amsoil Arena Cross main event number one, about to get underway as we take a look at the Monster Energy starting grid. The number one qualifier, he had the fastest heat race, Zach Ames, his teammate on the baddest Monster Energy Amsoil Kawasaki, Tyler Bowers, Gibson, Majors, Ginobili, looking through the field. Points are very critical, as after next week, we cut off the top 10 riders and they will race to the championship. Several riders in this field that are very close in points. Daniel Blair in ninth, Ginobili in 10th, 1 point ahead of Kyle White and Stephen Majors, all in this final.
Well, Kyle White actually not racing the lights class tonight because he's putting all his emphasis on this race. Let's see what happens.
Good start by Ames on the very inside. Right next to his teammate, looks like Majors on the outside, but it's Zach Ames with a hole shot. Kelly Smith trying to rail that outside. Is it Smith or is it Ames into the left-hander?
Bowers Ames now in the fourth, or is he third?
Make me second.
Now Kelly's going to have the inside. He gets back in this. He's got,
this could be
almost
close,
colliding in midair as they take off. Holy smoke, these guys are going for it.
You asked that question, does Zach Ames, what is it going to take to beat your teammate? Here's the first key to that puzzle.
Well, he's gotten out front. You know, Bowers now slips into third, but this is the time for Ames to show us that he can win, because he's shown that he's got the speed of Bowers. I feel that he's been a little bit intimidated by him in the past. He's now got a couple seconds over him, and if he can just mirror each other's lap time, this is his chance to shine again.
Nathan Skaggs, right number six, back and forth. Majors in fifth. Dave Ginobili just behind Stephen Majors. Two of those guys right around that top 10 bubble.
Yeah, pretty interesting there to see, you know, Dave Ginobili in sixth, Kyle White in seventh.
All three of them.
These guys know how important points are. We take a look at Kelly Smith, who's now sitting in the second position, actually putting a little distance between himself and Tyler Bowers. And like we said before, that's really critical in enabling these guys to open the track up and flow and not have to protect it inside.
Maybe even closing in a little bit on Zach Ames. Ames out in front. You see him staying on top of those hooks. A very strong line, able to cut across. He's doing everything perfect right now. And Bowers maybe closing in slightly on Kelly Smith just behind.
Because he is wheel tapping those rollers back there. So, you know, he's gaining some time by just carrying his momentum. Like Kelly Smith, he's coming, like, singling out of that, and that's hurting them. But watch,
look,
he's
going to
come to that section. Bowers is strong. Watch here.
That's two laps in a row.
Watch
he's
the
got
wheel tap. Oh, he did it that time. But still, close enough. Had the inside line. Very easy pass.
The case in point there was that he made sure he downsided that last hook that he set up in the corner, right?
Well, they both jumped out the signal, but if you've been watching Tyler throughout the evening as he's coming back to the section, he usually gives it a wheel tap somewhere, but no, going back to that kind of 2-3-1, at some point they were wheel tapping, as we see,
Davis Gag.
Yep, he's kind of skimming them a little bit, which I like. He's not bouncing out of that last one.
And these are guys who are right around the 10th bubble, guys like, you know, Ginobili, White, Majors, even Skaggs at some point. They're much higher in that order right now. Nathan Skaggs right inside the top five is the 14 of Ginobili. Look at him getting a little kick there. They'll get a little bonus pop if they're higher up the roster. 16 points for first, and you work your way down 1 point at a time.
See Kyle White doing that little wheel tap. You know what's funny is actually the man that he's trying to pass to get this chase for the championship is the number 14 of Dave Ginobili. He's 1 point behind him, and right now he's one position behind him as well.
They would be tied if they finished the same way. You see White on the outside looking at it, be one more point ahead of him. But getting kicked up, as Jeff Emick would say, the huckabuck.
Yeah. What's happening in these rooms is the third to last one is a little bit taller. So they're bouncing over that, and it's putting them into the face of the last one. So it's very important to try and use your body, the throttle, and just the full control. And now Jeff Gibson, runs into the back there of Willie Browning, I believe. So it's a little bit deeper in the field. Yeah, Stephen Majors in 7, Willie Browning 8, Jeff Gibson 9.
And Gibby's worked his way up. He was about 13th on that first lap. He's working his way up through the field. And as you said, pointed out, he is in 9th place right now.
Willie Browning going to the inside to protect it, but what happens, you see, he doesn't carry the momentum. Gibby's on the inside. Oh, we've got a battle for the lead, and Bowers up the inside of Ames. Teammates side by side.
Last lap also.
Has Ames fight back.
Watch him set up on the inside. No, he can't do it here. Can you believe this? Naughty had checked out and was going to pull away, but it is again Tyler Bowers on the last lap, making the last-ditch pass. And you know Bowers going probably, I can't believe I just made that pass. And his teammate, buddy, Zach Ames going, I can't believe I just let him make that pass.
I don't know, man. It looks to me that Bowers has gotten into Zach Ames' head because, come on, man, it's the last lap. Fight. You know, you got to give it everything. You got to beat this guy.
Look at the last lap. The last lap for Tyler Bowers is a 21-23, a 22-50. So 1.3 seconds quicker on that last lap made the difference. As we take a look at the AMSOIL results, Bowers, Ames, your teammates 1 and 2, Smith, Skaggs, Shinofi, a KTM triumvirate, Kyle White, Majors, Browning, Gibson, and Brandon Glenn rounding out the top 10 as we work our way through the field. But Tyler Bowers now makes it 3 in a row, and he's down with Christy Lee.
Tyler, yet another win. That makes 13 for you this season. Congrats.
Hey, thanks a lot. You know, got off to a decent start and just trying to make some moves earlier on. My team, Babbitt's, Montreal Energy, AMSOIL, Kawasaki, you know, working great tonight. It's just killing the whoops, and that's where I'm making most of my time. And made a smart pass there with my teammate Ames and got by him and just pumped to feel strong and ready for tonight.
Let's talk about the invert. You picked the number 8 last night as well. You ended up on the second row in the third position into turn 1, though. You moved all the way up that quickly, so obviously that was an advantage. Where are you going to go tonight?
Yeah, I think I'm probably going to try to go for the second row inside again. It's safe, you know. I'm a strong guy, and I can start second row and kind of weasel my way through and kind of move some people out of the way and get up front. You know, my trainer, Tyler Kalizak, just got me in great shape, and I'm feeling good for the whole 12 laps, and I'm just ready to charge through the pack and try to get another win under my belt.
Tyler Bowers trying to make it a perfect night, go 2 for 2, a ton of AMSOIL Arena Cross still to come right after this. AMSOIL Arena Cross isn't just about the big guys. It's also about the Groms, the little guys, the super minis, the 65s. They get to ride on the same track that the pros do.
This has got to be a dream come true for these kids. I mean, I know when I was a kid, I would have wished for an opportunity like this, being on the same track in front of the packed crowd, in front of your heroes. That's pretty awesome.
Yeah, there's been some big names that have rode the little bikes. Guys like Robbie Rayner, Trey Kennard. He's the best. Welcome back to Cedar Park, Texas for AMSOIL Arena Cross. Before we get to the basic action, let's go down to my partner, Grant Langston, on the start straight.
Well, guys, here at Cedar Park, the start is like nothing we've seen all season long. First of all, you got this short little chute that goes straight into the whoop section with a 45-degree angle. Plus, you got to go over the backside of the berm. Typically, we always see the guys starting on the inside and going into a 180 left so that, you know, play it safe. But tonight, if you swing it out a little bit wider, it is a little more risky because if you don't get the jump, you're going to get boxed out wide. But if you get the jump, you can cut over, keep your momentum, launch into this long whoop section, pin it down there, and you're probably guaranteed to get a hole shot.
Thanks a lot, GL. We'll look for that in the second main event. Now let's go over to Christy Lee, who's with the KTM rider, Dave Ginolfi.
Only 5 races remaining as we get closer to the race to the championship in Little Rock, Arkansas. A lot of pressure on you. You had a big competitor, Kyle White, who was only 1 point behind you leading into tonight's event. And he just finished behind you, which puts you at a 2-point advantage moving into main 2.
Yeah, thanks for all that information. I'm trying not to think about, but it makes it fun. Like you said, it's getting close. The past couple weeks, I've been really thinking about it, and I've been crashing and stuff, so I don't care anymore. I'm all about individual weekends. No one really remembers anyone but the champion, so top 10's cool for money, but no one will remember, so I'm all about each weekend.
Well, good luck coming into main 2.
All right, thanks a lot.
Thank you for the win, Christy, and we'll find out if he can do it. Main event number 2, we return.
Welcome back to the final race of the night. Amstel Arena Cross from Cedar Park, Texas. Let's take a quick look at the Monster Energy starting grid for this second main event. With an 8-rider inversion, you already heard Tyler Bowers talking about how he'd rather start on the second row inside instead of taking that outside starting grid.
Well, I feel like it's a double-edged sword. He's got confidence in himself of coming from the second row and winning, but he's also showing that he doesn't have the confidence in his starting ability because he didn't want to take that risky outside. Let's see how it pans out. Number two, Jeff Gibson.
You know he's smiling. Yeah. Well, you're going to give me a front row start, especially as good as he's going. I say watch the number two on the outside.
All four. And it's the number two from the outside, the gate that basically Tyler Bowers gave up. But Ginobili now to the lead. This guy means business. I just said I'm all about the individual
racing. I'm all about the win, baby. Tyler Bowers back in eighth place. That game looks like he's just on him at 9-10. How about Ginobili calling out the African Championship? How about wins, baby? Wins.
Oh, look at that. Moves by Gibby. Hugging the inside. And coming a little less of it for the next few days.
Look at this, Bowers. Listen, you can tell he's got his head down. He's coming. His training program definitely works.
makes a mistake. No! And they make contact.
Almost high side of it. He looks over going like, I can't let you cut back, but he's giving his save ball as well as power. And that has to disrupt him. It's giving him that fear. He's got to be devastated in a way that I don't know if anyone really wants to be fouled. He's coming. He's checking the flag. Tyler Bowen takes double tonight. I think he thinks he was trying to cut him off, but Jimmy, I think he's out of control there.
I think that was just unfortunate, but you know, you never like a guy jumping across in front of you.
He's upset, but I don't know that he necessarily intended to do it that much.
I don't think so.
As we look at the AMSOIL results for this second main event, Bowers, Gibson, Skaggs, Ames, and Smith, the top five as you work your way through the field. The overall perfect moto scores goes to Tyler Bowers. We'll hear from our top three when we return for AMSOIL Arena Cross, Cedar Park, Texas. Exciting night of AMSOIL Arena Cross here in Texas as we look at the overall results for the night. It's hard to beat 1-1 main event scores, and Tyler Bowers did just that on the Babbitts Kawasaki. Christy Lee's with him.
Tyler, another great weekend, another overall win for you here. And we're moving to the race to the championship in just four races. Are you looking forward to that?
Yeah, for sure. You know, I'm excited for it, but at the same time, I'm kind of bummed out. I got a nice little points gap right now, and it's all getting ready to disappear. So, you know, I've just been working hard, and I feel great on the bike. Yeah, I've been working out with Tyler Kalizak over at the Rockwell Training Facility, and I feel good. I feel strong on the bike. I'm just ready to get this championship points down.
Behind Tyler Bowers in the overall, his teammate who almost took that first main event victory is Zach Ames, and he's now with Christy.
Zach, more tight racing tonight. We saw you with the second overall finish here this weekend. You said you liked the whoop section. Well, this track was perfect for you because there were two whoop section out there. Congrats.
Yeah, thanks. You know, I knew I had to turn the weekends around. I had a couple bad weekends, but, you know, I went home, did my homework, just trained my butt off, and, you know, I come out here ready, and like you said, the two whoop sections played to my favor, and, you know, I just wanted to get off the start. I practiced on those, and just a solid weekend.
Solid night for the Motorsport.com KTM of Nathan Skaggs. After a third in that second main event, that's good enough to give him third overall. And Chrissy's with him.
Nathan, a lot of tight racing out there. The top 10 positions, a lot of position changes throughout the race, but you ended up in third. Congratulations.
Yeah, I got off to a pretty good start, you know, in both motos. You know, the bike's getting the Motorsport.com, JBR Spine Chillers, KTM's getting me off to good starts. Been working with the Whole Shot Works Connection device this weekend. I think I got her dialed in. You know, we got a couple more rounds and then we'd go for the chase. It's going to be a good one.
That's one of the AMSOIL Arena Cross Championship points. You got to be in that top 10 after Wilkes-Barre next weekend, and we have a tie for 10th place. Very important as we move into next weekend, Grant. You've got to be in 10th or you're basically racing for 11th place for the championship.
Absolutely. I mean, not a whole lot of changing in the, you know, top of the points there. Tyler Bowden racking up some more wins. But the biggest thing is we couldn't have asked for a better way to go to this final race before the chase for the championship. Then having riders tied for that final spot, it comes down to next week at Wilkes-Barre. I'm really excited, and this is exactly what we would have hoped for.
Isn't it funny, though, Ginobili, White, how they are, you know, so close in points, but on the track as well tonight?
At some point, I kept keeping an eye on them because I thought, is someone going to slam someone or go, you know what, get out of my way, man? So, basically, if you want to follow more on this, arenacross.com. Fantastic. A lot of information showing where the shows are, the live event coming up. I'm excited.
Don't forget, next week, live on Speed, followed by Monster Energy Supercross. You got to stay with us every week at AMSOIL Arena Cross. What a night tonight for Tyler Bowers. Takes the victory for Grant Langston, Christy Lee. I'm Robbie Floyd. We'll see you live next week right here on Speed.